my channel. My name is Dele, for those of you who may not know, and today I'm giving you guys a Morphe haul. If you guys looked at my previous video, I talked about the fact that I went to Texas last month and I was able to visit the Morphe store for the very first time. Visiting the Morphe store, I had never ordered anything online from Morphe, so this was like super exciting to me. Like, when I got to the mall, I didn't know that it was going to be a Morphe store. So when I seen the Morphe store, I literally had a moment. I feel like my boo knew that it was a Morphe store there because I hadn't been to that mall before while I was in Texas. So this specific time we went to this mall and I'm just like, is this Morphe? Like, I was literally in a state of shock. I wish he would have recorded how I was acting, because I just had a moment, because I just couldn't believe it. And I had never ever been to a Morphe store, and literally all the times I've been to LA, I didn't have a chance to go to the Morphe store. So this meant so much to me. I got so many good things. I got so many brushes, so many eyeshadow palettes. I have so much stuff to show you guys. So if you guys would like to see what I got from the Morphe store, then please keep on watching. So guys, all of my things came in this big black bag. And it's the same on both sides. I am obsessed with all of this stuff. Like, I am obsessed. I have eye brushes. I have face brushes. I wanted to kind of sort them out for you guys. And then some of these that's also in the wrapper, I didn't get a chance to open them because I got two of the same brushes for the most popular brushes. And then the face brushes are just everything. I got eyeshadow palettes. I've been using this stuff for the past few weeks, y'all, and I'm absolutely obsessed. I'm gonna start with the eyeshadow palettes. I got four palettes from the Morphe store. The first one I'm gonna show you guys is the 350M palette, which is all of your matte eyeshadows. So all of your matte eyeshadows is going to be in the 350 palette. I'm super obsessed with this palette because I love to wear like the warm oranges, the reddish tone oranges for like my transition shade. And I also feel like any eyeshadow look that you do, you're going to need matte colors. And literally this comes with all of the matte shades that you need. And as I stated in my previous video, I don't wear eyeshadow every single day, but I do like to wear a nice brown bronzer on my eyes. So I like to use this shade right here. And it's really like a reddish brown. And I absolutely love it. This palette is definitely a go. Like, I can just put one of these colors in my crease and keep it moving. The second eyeshadow palette is the 35M palette. And once again, this palette is filthy. I've been using these palettes on my clients as well as myself. So yeah, as you guys can see, it's definitely been used. I'm absolutely obsessed with this palette as well because it has matte colors as well as shimmer colors. And I feel like that's definitely key because you can use this one palette and create one look. You don't have to keep grabbing at different palettes. So that's actually what I do love about the palette. If you wanted to create a green look, you can go in this section. If you wanted to create a orangey look, you can go over here. Purple, you can go right here. You want more of a reddish vibe, you can go over here. So I feel like it definitely gives you a lot of different looks in one palette. And like I said, the shimmery shades are definitely very, very pigmented, as well as the matte ones are. So this is definitely a great palette as well. The third palette that I have for you guys is the 35R palette. And I haven't really used this much, as you guys can see, but this one also has both matte and shimmer shades. This side is matte and then this side is shimmery. And you have a lot of different colors to do, like transitional shades. And it's very warm and very bronzy, so I'm definitely obsessed with this palette. And today I actually used this color on my lids, mixed with a little bit of Fenty. But I absolutely love this palette as well. Like, it gives you a nice, you can get a mauve and a bronzy vibe from this palette. So this is definitely a yes. My absolute favorite palette, guys, have to be the Jaclyn Hill palette. And I love how on the back it has all of the shade colors. And it's so cute to me. I love it. I absolutely love it. And it's honestly dirty too because I've been using it. But it has a little bit of everything in it. You have your blue, your purple, mauve, and your dark browns. And you have a black. You have pinks, oranges, and you also have like a pastel pink row up here. So you can honestly do a lot of things with this palette. She has it set up to where even if you don't know what shades to use together, you can just look at the palette and be like, all right, cool. So I'm gonna use the dark one first, then I'm going with the light one. So I feel like she makes it extremely, extremely easy for you to use her palette. I also love the message above. It says, this palette is dedicated to all my loving subscribers. XO Jaclyn. Jaclyn, you definitely did it, sis, with this palette. I love the white and silver. It's so cute. I just love it. So I use this palette just as much as I use the 35OM palette. Next, I'm going to show you guys my brushes. These are my eye brushes. I also have face brushes as well. So I'm going to first go over the eye brushes. I have the M532, which is a really good brush for a transition shade. And if you guys don't know what a transition shade is, it's the shade that you use first before you do any other shade. Like, it's literally like the background shade. Like, do you see like the warm orange? It's like the shade that you will put before you start your, before you really go in with your color of choice. And I just love this brush because you literally can just, it's literally so soft and fluffy and smooth. And it just glides on your eyes so smoothly. And I just love it. Like, I got about 3 of these because I know how irresponsible I am. I lose a lot of things. So just to assure that I always have this brush, I made sure I got more than one. And this brush is definitely a must have. Even if you want to do one shade, like when I do that brown shade on my eyelid, just that one shade, I use this one brush and just sweep it across and I'm good to go. The second brush that I absolutely have been loving is the R39 brush. And it's basically a white goat hair brush. I love it for putting things in my crease. Like if you want it to be like very defined, you want to use this type of brush because the bristles are very like condensed and packed. And I just love how it just holds everything together. So this is definitely one of those brushes that I got multiples of. Another brush that I've absolutely been obsessing over is the M535. This is also a fluffy brush as well, and I feel like to compare, this brush is a mixture of these two brushes together. It's very dense, but it's also fluffy at the same time. So you can also use this as a transition brush or as a crease brush, however you want to do it. Another brush is the Morphe M411. I love this brush too. Honestly, you can, it's like a taper, it's like a pointed taper brush. And I love this brush to like really get into my crease or my lower outer V if you wanted to use it for that. Also, I like to use this brush to like contour my nose as well because it's so tiny and dense and it has that point to it, so you can like control it very easily. You can honestly also use this brush to like put highlighter like in a crease if you wanted to. And this is another brush that I have multiples of too. Next is the M224 brush. I love this brush to pack on like shadow. I use this brush today to pack on my shadow. Once again, I used a gold shade from the Morphe palette, and I also used the Fenty Beauty Trophy Wife. If you guys have ever used Trophy Wife from Fenty Beauty, you know that after you grab it from the actual pan, it gets a little loose as you apply it. But this brush actually keeps the shadows very dense and put together. And you also can just glide it on your eyes so easily. I love it. I actually only got one of these and I kind of wish I got more of them because I'm absolutely obsessed with this brush. So now there is the R37 brush. I like this brush also to go ahead and just, I like to kind of contour my eye shape, if that makes sense to you. I like to just, you know, run it in between here and connect it with my nose and my eyebrow. And I feel like this is big enough and also fluffy enough to do that. And I also love like the gold accent with the black. It's super cute. Next, I have the M326 brush. I love this brush because I like to use it as either a lip brush or a brush to do like my bottom shadow. I have really small eyes, so like I need like a tiny brush to just get right under there and just do exactly what I needed to do. Next, there is the M218 brush. And I like this brush because it's like a really good like setting brush for like my nose, my chin, like just to get like small areas that you want to set. You can even set your whole under eye with this brush if you wanted to. So I really, really love this for that as well. And I feel like you can also use it for face and eyes. You don't really necessarily have to use it only on your face. Honestly, guys, Morphe have so many brushes that I wanted to grab one of each, but I also had to be a lot more rational and think like, do I really need all of these brushes? Let me see how these work first before I actually get all of them. So I would honestly say the brushes that I've named are the brushes that you're going to need to complete any eyeshadow look. And if you want to get multiples of them, that'll be smart as well. But if you also wanted to grab other brushes, that's cool too. But these are like the main brushes that you're going to need for the perfect eyeshadow look. So on to the face brushes. I didn't get too many face brushes only because I feel like face brushes aren't really as important to me as eye brushes are, I feel like you can really just do your face with just any brush, honestly. It's not that deep. But honestly, I've gained a lot of love for certain brushes that I actually purchased. The first is the M501 brush. I've heard so much about this brush. And this is a really, really good brush for setting your under eyes. You can apply your cheek highlight with this. You can apply blush. You can blend out powder and highlighter. But I love this for like setting underneath my eyes and like my nose and everything. And just patting everything. This is like the perfect brush. And it's so fluffy and so just, I cannot do my makeup without this brush, y'all. I cannot. Like, before I was using this brush, I was using a beauty blender to set under my eyes. And I loved it. But once I came across this, I started setting my makeup with this. And I absolutely love it. I got like 6 of these because I'm just obsessed. I'm so obsessed. Another brush that's really, really good to set with is the M438 brush. This is actually very similar to the M501. But as you guys can see, it's a lot thicker and it's a lot more dense. It's not as fluffy as this. So this one is also good for setting too. But I'm so obsessed with the M501. But this is also good for setting. I've used it once and I like it. Just not as much. But you can try it to see how you like it. Next, there is the R36 brush. And this is also very similar to the M501. The only difference between it is the hairs are a lot longer and it's goat hair. So goat hair isn't going to be as smooth and fluffy as regular brush hair. But I love this for applying like my highlighter. Also, just to go over like the rough patches of my nose. Because sometimes like when I do my nose, it gets kind of difficult and I have to blend extra hard. I have to blend like double the amount that I would blend everything else. So this is really good to make sure I remove all of that excess like powder. Next is the M405 brush, and I love this brush for just applying like bronzer and just buffing out like my contour. I really love this brush. It's so fluffy and just everything. And I definitely use this brush. I use this brush quite a lot because, as you can see, it's still kind of dirty. Next is the R10 brush. And I love this brush for just applying like a contour or a blush. And then I like to blend it out with this. Or I even like to blend it out with the angle brush. So Also, I'm obsessed with the rose gold chrome. I love the rose gold chrome. I really wish all of their brushes had that. But I really love just how dense this is. You can literally just pack it on and then just blend it out. Next is the R1 brush. And this is just a really stupid, dumb, big, fluffy brush, honestly. Like, it's so big of a brush. I'm not a huge fan of super, super big brushes because I don't feel like it's necessary for my face size. But this brush is really good for all over setting. I like to set my face with, like, a loose powder. So I like to dip it in the powder and just go over it. And it just, you know, lightly blend it in. And it does a really good job at that. I actually have two of these. I left this one in the box because I just want to use it as a souvenir. I'm such a hoarder, guys. Like, sometimes I literally want to save stuff just to have it. I don't really know why I think that way, but I just never opened it because I just feel like I'm using it. I'm just saving it as a souvenir. I don't know what's wrong, but I love this because it grows after you damp it under the sink. So I really love this for blending on my foundation. I also got a chance to grab some of the Morphe Solid Brush Cleaner. And I got the coconut. Actually, it's cocoa butter. And it smells so good. It literally smells like a candle. I'm obsessed with candles. It smells so good, y'all. I don't even want to use it because it smells so good. I just want to save it. Like, I'm so weird. It smells so freaking good. But this is good for if you are in between clients, you want to hurry up and wash your sponge, dip it in there, wet it, squeeze it, it's clean. Or you can even put some water in here, swirl around your brush, and clean your brush that way. This is basically on-the-go brush cleaner. Next, I have a brush storage, like a travel case. And I need this because when I travel, my makeup is not organized, guys. I'm just being completely honest. My stuff is all over the place. It's a mess. So I grabbed this. And it smells like pleather. But I grabbed this so that I could put all of my brushes in here. Like this. And when I travel, I could just put it in this big case. Like that. So I can just pull all my brushes in here, put it in my suitcase. Like, this is probably like my favorite item from Morphe. It is the Morphe spray. It's called the Continuous Setting Spray. I'm absolutely obsessed with this. Like, the little, it sprays so fine and misty. Like, it sprays so good. I got like 40s. I'm on my last one because this is how much I use it. I use it on myself and my clients. But I love it because it locks in your makeup. It has a very smooth, like, hairspray misty type of vibe. So I love that about it. And it has a really good smell. It doesn't break me out. And I just love it, guys. It's just, I'm obsessed. So the last thing that I got, it actually was a gift. My boo actually surprised me. He sent me a picture of the Morphe bag, but he never said what was in it. So when I got there, he gave me a brush belt. And this is basically perfect for makeup artists. You do not have to keep reaching in your makeup bag or your makeup case or your makeup brush stand. You can literally just put this on your waist, grab whatever brushes that you need, which I still haven't even used these brushes yet because I've been using those. But you literally can grab whatever brushes you need and you're good to go. So thanks, babe. Well, guys, that's it for today. I really hope you guys enjoyed this makeup related video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.